3, 2, 1, 0. And liftoff.
Commercial space operators are conducting an increasing number of launches and reentries, as many as 2 operations per month. In the coming years, that pace is expected to increase dramatically. For today's space launch and reentry missions, the Federal Aviation Administration closes off large areas of the National Airspace System, or NAS, for long periods. This precaution protects other aircraft in case a launch or reentry vehicle breaks apart.
When commercial space started to gain momentum and we saw operations launching to orbit and reentering from orbit, we applied the same approaches as we were using for the shuttle.
Up to 6 FAA personnel manually track the vehicle's trajectory on paper. They share that data with other traffic managers who are monitoring the airspace via telephone and the internet.
We had just a screen of numbers, state vectors, lat-long coordinates of the vehicle, and we would enter those manually.
This process is time-consuming and creates opportunities for errors. Enter the Space Data Integrator, or SDI. This tool, being developed by the FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation, will feed real-time commercial space vehicle trajectory and mission status data into the next-gen traffic flow management system.
This displays on the screen that the air traffic controllers have in front of them.
The SDI will also help the FAA respond quickly if a launch or reentry vehicle breaks up in flight. The FAA can quickly identify the airspace at risk while leaving the rest of the NAS open.
We have a risk assessment tool that's able to predict where debris or hazard could be, and the air traffic controllers are then able to remove aircraft from that hazard area.
The SDI tool will help reduce the amount of airspace closed in advance of a launch or reentry. It will enable air traffic controllers to respond quickly to unexpected events and to release airspace faster once it's no longer affected. An SDI prototype is currently being tested, and it's expected to be in use by the FAA in 2020.